ده حديث أبو جابر رضي الله عنه regarding the pilgrimage of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم includes the major rulings concerning Hajj, which is what Imam Muslim رحمه الله narrated from Jabir ibn Abdullah رضي الله عنهما that the Prophet stayed in Medina for 9 years without performing Hajj. Then in the 10th year, it was announced to the people that he would be performing Hajj. So a large number of people headed toward Medina, all hoping to accompany him and do what he does, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Furthermore, it is obligatory upon the Mukallaf to perform Hajj as soon as possible. We left accompanying him until we reached Dhul Hudhayfa. At that time, Asma bint Umais gave birth to Muhammad bin Abi Bakr and sent someone to the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, asking, "What should I do?" He said, in the meaning of which, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "Perform ghusl, wrap a cloth around your privates, and enter into ihram." And in the hadith of Aisha, when she menstruated, he said to her, "Do whatever a hajj does, except that you shouldn't perform tawaf around the house, i.e. the Kaaba, until you become pure." The Prophet ﷺ prayed in a masjid, then got on al-Qaswa, his female camel. And then, when his camel got on the path al-Bayda, he started saying the talbiyah, "Labbaik Allahumma labbaik, labbaik la sharika laka labbaik, إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك." The people also pronounced the stelbia that they, i.e. the Sahaba, pronounced. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not stop them from any of them. The Messenger of Allah continued to say his own talbiyah, i.e. stuck to his own wording. Jabir radiallahu anhu said, "Our intention was only for Hajj and nothing else. We did not know of Umrah. When we reached the house, i.e. the Kaaba, with him, he touched a corner, a Yemeni corner, with the black stone, and then he made 7 tawafs, jogging through 3 and walking 4. He then went to Maqam Ibrahim and recited, 'Take the Maqam of Ibrahim as a place of prayer.' He then prayed 2 rak'ahs, with the Maqam being located between him and the house. In another narration, it has been reported that he recited in the 2 rak'ahs, قل هو الله أحد سورة الإخلاص and قل يا أيها الكافرون سورة الكافرون. He then returned to the corner that, and touched it. Afterwards, he left from the gate towards Mount Safa. When he got to close to Mount Safa, he recited the verse, "As-Safa and Marwa are among the symbols of Allah." He then climbed it until he saw the house. Then he faced the Qibla and said, لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير لا إله إلا الله وحده أنجز وعده ونصر عبده وهزم الأحزاب وحده. There is no deity beside Allah. He is alone and with no partners. For him is all sovereignty and praise, and he is over all things qadir, able to do. There is no deity except Allah alone. He fulfilled his promise, aided his servant, and alone defeated the Ahzab. Then he supplicated between that during this 3 times.